Hello everyone, John Frost with Topspin Tennis. In this video, I'm going to break down Flavia Panetta's first serve. She actually won the Women's US Open in 2015. She was a number one doubles player in the world. She's from Italy. Got a great game, so I thought, let's look at her serve in super slow motion, shot at 240 frames per second. Enjoy the video. So let's break down the serve, show you some of the magic moves that she has with the serve, some things that really make it very effective. Continental grip with the grip. One thing I want you to notice with this bilateral move here, as she starts tossing, notice how a lot of times what will happen with this hand is it'll start dropping this way. Notice how when she does the scissors move, her hand, her hitting hand actually stays above the ball here. And then she is going to release the toss. So a little different motion here. She's not really scissoring here where she lets that racket head drop. It actually moves with the tossing arm. One thing I want you to watch that I really like is just notice the lag here, how the hand leads and the racket head stays in front. This is going to allow, I mean, it just tells you there's not a lot of arm tension with the grip, so she allows for that lag. She tosses the ball. Notice how the racket head is still in front of the hand in this position. Currently she is in a platform stance, but as we proceed you'll see how she gets into a pinpoint stance. So good toss usually is going to be released right around the eyes or top of the head, so she's right in line with the typical toss as well. Her tossing arm is facing the right net post. We can't see it in the video, but usually this arm here, the shoulder, will point towards that right net post. Let's go ahead and look at the release of the toss and her trophy pose. One thing I want you to watch and notice how this tossing arm gets beyond vertical here. That's a great position because what's going to happen is she's going to get great shoulder tilt and full trophy pose. So this is a common error with a lot of beginners and intermediate players. Their arm does not get to that position. We'll see the arm, you know, get to here, tossing arm, it'll stop here, possibly here. But if you want to really get into a good loading position and really store this energy, I'd recommend getting into this position here with that hand. So that's a perfect position. Notice how her racket head is up. And the other thing I want you to notice too is just notice the spacing with her elbow and her body. You don't want this elbow tucked in. You want to get some good spacing. And as we get into this trophy pose, and this is that platform stance that I talked about, do you see that? Look at the phenomenal shoulder tilt that she gets in this position. So that's fantastic. I believe because of this tilt and the platform stance that she's gonna get this better bowing of the hip and the side of the body and the leg. So you can see that bowing position as well. That's part of the service code or the serve code that Chuck Tomlin and John Carpenter came up with from Congruent Tennis. So if that bowing position is a standard position with the serve code. One other thing I want you to keep in mind is just notice her lips, how they're almost touching that bicep. So if you want to really get into this position here with that tossing arm, just tell yourself you're going to kiss that bicep before you hit the ball. Racket head is up, feet are together in that pinpoint stance, and then let's go ahead and look at the racket drop. Racket drops into that slot beautifully here. And notice the hand to elbow position, so some good flexibility here. But here's that launching phase where she utilizes that ground and that rotation to accelerate up and to the ball. So great position here. Racket drops into the slot really well. The arm starts tucking in here, and let's look at the contact point. There's the contact point. Once again, what a lot of beginner intermediates are not doing is they are not finding that ball in the court. Beautiful contact. Notice her hitting arm. Look at the extension here. So that's really good. And then you can see her non-tossing arm, how it tucks in here. And then the shoulder turn and the hip turn to the court is really, really good. So we've got different forces here. She's rotating, she's launching up. Very, very good serve. One thing I did want you to notice too is notice the tip in the racket. Notice how the racket head is laid back a little bit in this position. A lot of times with the men, because of racket head speeds, this racket head will be out in front a little bit. Some of the players on the tour don't have the same racket head speed, so this racket head may be laid back a little bit just to get the clearance over the net. Let's go ahead and look at the pronation. Notice how she finishes. So she hit through and across the ball and then finishes to her right. Look at her landing out into the court. So she's basically landing with that left foot. If you remember where I drew that line on her contact point, this was the contact point. That contact point and foot will line up a lot of times on the serve. So that's why it's so important to get that toss into the court. And then the finish obviously is going to be across the body. And now from here, she has options. Is she going to step up and attack? Is the return going to be hit deep and she's got to back up? But a lot of options. Love the serve. If you haven't done so yet, make sure you hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and that notification bell as well. If you really like the video, please share it with your friends, family, coaches, and players. Have a great day.